I was reading something. When Matthew Stafford put that arm sleeve on, he turned into Patrick Mahomes. What a coincidence, though. I got some gameplay versus the Kansas City Chiefs. And before I say anything, if you guys enjoy my videos, go ahead and like and subscribe if you haven't already. Check out the first play of scrimmage, DeSean Jackson. Could he go all the way? That speed burst. And it's so crazy that DeSean Jackson's been in the NFL, I think, for over more than 10 years, I would say. Maybe. I don't know. It's been quite a while. He played with the Buccaneers. He's played with the Redskins, or the Washington football team. And he also played with the Philadelphia Eagles, which was his home. And needless to say, he's now with the Rams. And man, oh man, his speed is just outstanding, just incredible. I don't know how he still manages to have that blazing speed. With that being said, though, Matthew Stafford. I don't know. I'm just really excited for Matthew Stafford. His cannon now. I know they played the Bears. The Bears is just a lot of controversy going on with their quarterback, but that was week one. And today is week two. By the time the video releases, let me know your guys' picks for your favorite team. Look at Patrick Mahomes on a 4th and 10. Look at this, man. Just completely having all day in the pocket. And my opponent, I'm not going to spoil anything, but I don't know. I felt like this game right here, it didn't really feel like a competition. It felt like more, I got to stop that play specifically. So needless to say, you guys should stay tuned for this one. It is a long game, and a long throw to Tyreek Hill attempt was incomplete. Shout out to Williams for making that great defensive play. However, like I kept saying, my opponent with Patrick Mahomes snaps it. What is my corner doing up there? My safeties, it's cover three, and Tyreek Hill just seems to get open for no reason. I don't know what's going on with my DBs there. However, we got to score every single possession. And the Rams, they have an amazing receiving core. They got Cooper Kupp, Robert Woods, and again, DeSean Jackson, along with the running back. The running backs is okay. Like, I forgot who they have at running back, but I don't know his name. He was playing very good, solid for me. Sorry, Rams fan. He was playing amazing. Needless to say, the Rams just in general, man, they just have a squad. And look at this touchdown hitting the tight end. And like I said in many videos, whenever I play against the Chiefs or the Ravens or the Packers, you got to bring your A game, because Patrick Mahomes, look at this. He's already on the X factor, like 15-yard plus bonus when he throws it, and just straight up bullets right here. Look at Tyreek Hill making that first down catch. Now, I enjoy playing against opponents that give me tough games, even if it's like this. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but those PA actions, like these little crossing routes, and look at this. What is my corner or safety doing there? Like, it felt like he was just fading away. Like the receiver was running, Tyreek Hill was running the specific route that made my safety not react. So it was kind of annoying not being able to get something going on defense there. However, it's 3rd and 9. We can't complain. It's just football. And anyways, at the end of the day, I'm sure football games, there's going to be moments where opponents just cannot stop scoring. Just like me, I'm just driving downfield a lot of times. And Matthew Stafford right here showing his legs. Let's freaking get it. Stafford has a competition of being, I mean, I might get a lot. This is a very bold statement. I'm going to say this, Rams fan. You guys should definitely, you guys should support me on this one. Does Matthew Stafford have the potential to be the NFL's MVP player of the year offensively? That is a very bold statement. You got a lot of quarterbacks already, like Kyler Murray, Jameis Winston, already having like 5 touchdowns in their first game. So, hey, shout out to those quarterbacks. But I truly believe that Stafford, especially, man, I feel like this team with the Rams, it was kind of a refreshment. And what I mean by refreshment is he just needed to get out of Detroit. I don't know what's going to happen with Goff. As much as I love Goff, and I feel like Goff has done more in his career than Matthew Stafford has, I feel like, again, it's a refreshment for both players. But I feel like Matthew Stafford was put in a better position. Players with, again, Aaron Donald, Jalen Ramsey on defense, I think that's just what the Rams need to start doing, is to start utilizing those players, because I think it's time. Now, even though they went to the Super Bowl a few years ago, it's time for them to show out with Matthew Stafford and Patrick Mahomes right there just getting a touchdown. Right here, 40 seconds left before the end of the first half. Let's get it. Cooper Kupp, oh my goodness, breaking tackles out here. Let's do it. Getting out of bounds. That's the number one goal. It's to either get out of bounds or call a timeout. We have more than enough timeouts to get something going here, so we're not trying to force nothing just yet. Right here, though, Matthew Stafford snaps it, trying to get someone going and hitting the running back. I believe that's Henderson Jr. If I'm wrong, go ahead, throw any shade at me, okay? I'm not tripping. I might be wrong. But right here, though, 2nd and 5, look at my boy Cooper Kupp. And for the touchdown, let's get it. Matthew Stafford, just the ability to make these throws, just straight up bullets. It's just coming into clutchness. Heading into the end of the first half, let's get it. Once again, if you guys are enjoying my videos, like and subscribe. Appreciate that. Comment your favorite team. Also, comment how your team's going to do this morning, because I live in California, so it's going to be pretty early. I got to wake up early, so I got to wake up around 9:30-ish or 9-ish and try to go get some breakfast. That's one thing I want to do, is to go get breakfast and make sure I'm watching the game good and then head straight to work. But right here, my opponent, again, this is a very high-scoring game. 21-24, we're up by a field goal. Mahomes scanning the field and finding Nicole Hardman. And Hardman, the Chiefs have a lot of speed on their wide receiving core. But honestly, the fastest player that you see, there's the thing about speed players, and especially with the 40-yard dash, a lot of these players have that ridiculous 40-yard dash. And right here, interception by Jalen Ramsey. Finally, I get something going with defense, especially with Jalen Ramsey. The thing about 4-3 or players that run fast 40s, it doesn't correlate or translate into an actual NFL game. And I feel like that's what Tyreek Hill does. That's what Antonio Brown does. Those are receivers, Nicole Hardman. And check out this play right here. Stafford extending the play and throws it up. If that was Madden 25 or like Madden 13, that would have been a pick. Because players in those previous games jumped completely ridiculously high. But going back to my point, yes, speed, I feel like you need to utilize it a lot different. Not just having speed. You got to have the route technician. You got to have the ability to catch. Right here, though, look at this crossing pattern. This was a pick play. If you look at my left wide receiver, my right wide receiver, if you rewind that, my whole decision and plan was to cross DeSean Jackson and cross my left wide receiver. So that way, my opponent doesn't have no one else to use her. And I know he was going to either pick one. And I just have to get rid of the ball. So we came in clutch. And even with Jalen Ramsey having the X factor ability on, just gets completely burned. Like, it's like, what? Now, don't get me wrong. I understand Tyreek Hill is fast, but a 99 overall corner and Jalen Ramsey, come on, man. We got to get something going there. Same pick play right here. DeSean Jackson. This is a very interesting decision I made. I ended up not going for the touchdown to waste my opponent's timeout. Now, at the end of the day, nothing matters unless I score a touchdown. No field goals. The way my opponent playing on offense, we cannot settle for field goals. And Matthew Stafford, bullet inside for a touchdown. DeSean Jackson. This game isn't over, though, guys. The way my opponent's playing, he's just completely making it look so easy. It's just kind of crazy. It's just like, bruh, I can't do anything on defense. Look at Patrick Mahomes right here. Only a minute left and just, oh my goodness. If you guys are watching this video up to this point, what can I do to stop this? Because I couldn't stop it. I was just like, no, we're just giving up too many easy yards. Right here, Mahomes making some Peyton Manning audibles, snaps a ball. No one's open and just making it look easy. However, though, the onside kick is clearly coming. However, can you guess what happens right here? My opponent goes into onside formation. Let's see if we can recover it. He ends up kicking it, and we get it. And just like that, my opponent ends up quitting. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. Football today, really excited. Let me know your guys' thoughts on today's games as well at whatever point you're watching it. Really appreciate you guys staying tuned for this one. And as always, peace out and have a great day. And let's get it.